Hello everyone, my name is Demis Moon and this is my assistant The Foot. Today we'll talk about Plato's theory of forms. My plan is to cover Plato's whole philosophy in the next several videos, but his theory of forms is the foundation for understanding his whole body of work. So in this first video, we'll focus on what forms are and how Plato used them to understand the world. So what are forms? Another name for them are ideas, from the Greek word eidos. And this is what they are in essence, ideas. But what is an idea? An idea is a universal, in other words, something which covers many individual examples of the same kind. For instance, there are many different kinds of dogs, different races, little dogs, large dogs, but there is also a form or an idea of a dog or dogness. There is something unique, essentially unique, to all different kinds of dogs, otherwise we would not call them all dogs. When you answer the question, what is a dog? Not this or that particular dog, but dogness as such, you have the form. Similarly, there are many happy things in this world, a happy foot, a happy dog, but all of these things share the common characteristic that they are now happy. But Plato then asked the question, okay, both are happy, but what is happiness itself? What does it mean to be happy? So when you say this is a happy small dog, then there are three forms present here. The form of happiness, the form of smallness, because there is also a form of smallness like anything else, and the form of dogness. Forms, or ideas as their name implies, are ideal. They cannot be found in material reality. When you see a happy dog, you see it with your eyes. You see an individual dog. Similarly, if the dog is dirty, you can smell it. When it barks, you can hear it. Individual things, such as a dog, and their characteristics, such as their happiness, are accessible through our senses. They are material sensibles. Ideas, on the other hand, are not accessible through the senses, but only through reason. You cannot see, smell, hear, or touch an idea. You can only reach an idea by thinking. In other words, they are objects of reason and knowledge, not of senses. You can point to individual examples in the sensible world. You can point to a tree or a dog, but you cannot point to an idea or the form. You can only think it. And to think an idea means to focus on that which makes the thing what it is, that without which it would not be what it is. Dogs can be of many different sizes and they may smell differently depending on how clean they are, or be happy and sad. The form of dogness points to the essential feature of a dog, regardless if it is small or large, clean or dirty. However, here now comes the twist. Ideas for Plato are not ideas in our head, they are not just mental ideas. They exist in themselves, independent from us. They are real, and in fact they are more real than all individual things. According to Plato, they exist in another realm, the world of forms. And this world is immaterial, it is beyond space and time. So whereas an individual dog exists in space and time, in other words, it is extended in space and changes through time, now it's dirty and later it's not. The idea of dogness is not to be found anywhere and does not pass through time. Bound by space and time, all individual things change and perish, but ideas, since they exist in the eternal realm, are unchanging. There are therefore two worlds in Plato's philosophy. The world of sensible things, things we can see, touch, smell, hear, and the world of forms, which are beyond space and time, which can only be taught and are accessible to reason. So how do these two worlds interact? Well, according to Plato, every single thing or characteristic imitates the form or idea of which it is an instance. So for example, this individual dog imitates the form of dogness itself. More precisely, an individual dog is an imperfect copy of the form of dogness, which itself is the eternal model for all dogs to imitate. By imitating forms, all individual things participate in them. And this is the second way in which Plato understands the relationship between universal forms and individual things. All dogs participate in the idea of dogness. In other words, they take part in being a dog, or rather they share in the universal dogness which is embodied in them. All individual dogs also participate in other forms. So for example, some dogs imitate and participate in the form of smallness, as a result of which they are small, while others in the form of largeness, and so they are large. Individual things are multiform. They imitate many different eternal forms. An individual dog imitates the idea of dogness, but also other forms, the form of happiness, the form of largeness and smallness, the form of youthness and oldness. and it is these mixtures that change over time in the sensible world. The dog imitates the form of dogness and the form of youthness, but with time it becomes older. It ceases to participate in the form of youthness and instead starts imitating the form of oldness. And so, individual things change through space and time depending on what kind of mixtures they are in. Forms or ideas, on the other hand, are simple. They are mixed with nothing. The idea of happiness is only that, the perfect happiness and nothing else. The idea of a dog is only that, the eternal perfect dogness, pure and simple and nothing else. Individual things exist, they have being only on account of sharing in the being of the forms, which are perfect and have the most being. In other words, forms are the most real things there are, and everything else is like an imitation, an imperfect shadow of them. When individual things cease imitating the form or participating in the form, they perish, they have no existence which is independent. When you do something that makes you happy, you participate in the form of happiness. But when you have a bad day of sleep and feel horrible, you participate less in the form of happiness. Or you get completely depressed and you cease participating in the form of happiness altogether. You are utterly unhappy. And badness, unhappiness, ugliness, these negative characteristics, according to Plato, are deficiencies. There are no negative forms or ideas of bad things. Unhappiness, ugliness, is just a lack of participation in the form of happiness or the form of beauty. Just like when the dog dies, it ceases to participate in the eternal dogness. It becomes just matter. Why are there no bad forms, according to Plato? Well, besides all the forms of anything or any characteristic, form of youthness, form of beauty, form of happiness, form of dogness, smallness or largeness, there is one supreme form above all others. This is the form or the idea of the good. And the form of the good is like the king of all the forms in the eternal world. So there is even something higher than the forms. They have a king, which is the form of the good. Why is the form of the good the highest and above all others? Because all forms are good. All of them are good. There is no badness in the forms. They are perfection, pure and simple. Justice is good. Beauty is good. Eternal darkness is good. All forms, as ideals and perfect models for everything, are by nature good. Therefore, world of sensible things imitates the forms and by imitating the forms aspires toward goodness. In other words, toward perfection. So to aspire toward the good by imitating forms is to aspire toward an ideal, which however can never be reached in the sensible world because it always remains an imitation. It can only be reached in thought and knowledge. And in the next video, we'll talk about Plato's theory of knowledge. Thank you very much and until next time.